Hello everyone, myself A.S. Falmari, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the last video, we have discussed the definition and some examples of the Jacobian. Now, in this video, we consider some properties of the Jacobian and the examples based on that properties. Learning outcome of this session is, at the end of this session, students will be able to find the Jacobian of given functions. Now, let us consider the properties of the Jacobian. Now, the first property is, if J is the Jacobian of UV with respect to XY and J dash is the Jacobian of XY with respect to UV, then J into J dash is equal to 1. That is, Jacobian of UV with respect to XY into Jacobian of XY with respect to UV is equal to 1. Now pause this video and write down the formula for finding the Jacobian of UVW with respect to XYZ. I hope that all of you have written the answer. The Jacobian of UVW with respect to XYZ is defined by the 3 cross 3 determinant, in which the first row contains the partial derivatives of U with respect to XYZ. Second row contains the partial derivatives of V with respect to XYZ. And finally, the third row contains the partial derivatives of W with respect to XYZ. Let us consider examples. Example number 1, if X equal to U into cos V, Y equal to U into sin V, prove that Jacobian of UV with respect to XY into Jacobian of XY with respect to UV is equal to 1. Solution: here we have given X and Y in terms of UV. Therefore, first we find the Jacobian of XY with respect to U and V. Now, differentiating X partially with respect to U, treating V constant, we get, now cos V is constant and the derivative of U with respect to U is 1. Now, differentiating X partially with respect to V, treating U constant, as U constant we can write U constant as it is, and the derivative of cos V is minus sin V. Now, consider the next function Y. Differentiating Y partially with respect to U, treating V constant, as V constant we can write sin V as it is, into the derivative of U with respect to U is 1. And finally, partial derivative of Y with respect to V, treating U constant, is equal to, as U is constant we can write U as it is, and the derivative of sin V is cos V. Now, by the definition, Jacobian of XY with respect to UV is defined by this 2 by 2 determinant. Now, substituting all these partial derivatives in this determinant, we get this determinant. Now, evaluating it, cos V into the bracket U into cos V minus sin V into the bracket minus U into sin V. Now, after multiplying by cos V to this bracket, we get it as U into cos square V, and this minus minus will be plus U into sin V is sin square V. Now, let us take U common from these two terms. We get it as U into the bracket cos square V plus sin square V, and this bracket has the value 1. Therefore, 1 into U is U. Therefore, this U is the value of Jacobian of XY with respect to UV. Now, our next aim is to find out the Jacobian of UV with respect to XY. In order to find this Jacobian, we must have UV as a function of two independent variables X and Y. In order to obtain this, we have to solve these two equations for U and V. Now, first, let us consider the ratio Y by X, which is equal to, where Y is U sin V and X is U cos V. Here we can remove this U, and sin V upon cos V is tan V. in order to have an expression in terms of v, let us operate tan inverse on both sides. So we get it as v equal to tan inverse of y by x. Now here we have obtained v as a function of xy. Now let us differentiate this v partially with respect to x, treating y constant. Now here v is tan inverse of y by x. Now it has the derivative 1 upon 1 plus y by x bracket square, that is y square upon x square, into the derivative of y by x with respect to x is minus y upon x square. Now after cross multiplication, we get this term as x square upon x square plus y square into, now this minus we can write here, minus y by x square. Now we can remove this x square and finally we get the derivative as minus y upon x square plus y square. Again, differentiating v partially with respect to y, treating x constant. Now the derivative is 1 upon 1 plus y by x square, that is y square upon x square, into the derivative of y by x with respect to y is 1 upon x. Now after cross multiplication, we get this term as x square upon x square plus y square into the bracket 1 upon x. Now here we can remove 1x from the numerator and denominator and we get the derivative as x upon x square plus y square. Now in the next one, now we have to express u in terms of xy. To express this, now consider the relation x square plus y square, where we know that x is u cos v, therefore x square is u square cos square v plus, and we know that y is u sin v, therefore y square is u square sin square v. From these two terms, we can take u square common and then we get u square into the bracket cos square v plus sin square v. Now we know that cos square v plus sin square v has the value 1, therefore we get the final relation as u square is equal to x square plus y square. Now differentiating this relation partially with respect to x, treating y constant, we get 2u into dou u by dou x is equal to, now the derivative with respect to x is 2x. Now dividing this relation by 2u, we get dou u by dou x is equal to x upon u. Now differentiating this relation partially with respect to y, treating x constant, we get 2u into dou u by dou y is equal to derivative of x square plus y square with respect to y, treating x constant is 2y. Dividing this relation by 2u, we get dou u by dou y is equal to y by u. Now we have obtained all these four derivatives. By the definition, Jacobian of uv with respect to xy is defined by this 2 by 2 determinant. Now substituting all these four partial derivatives in this determinant, we get this determinant. Now simplifying it, we get x by u into the bracket x upon x square plus y square minus y by u into the bracket minus y upon x square plus y square. Now x upon u into this bracket, we get it as x square upon u into the bracket x square plus y square. Now this minus minus is plus, y into y is y square upon u into the bracket x square plus y square. Now here the denominators are same, therefore we can add both these quantities. We get it as the numerators are x square plus y square divided by u into the bracket x square plus y square. Now we can remove this x square plus y square and we get the final Jacobian as 1 upon u. Now let us consider the required product, Jacobian of xy with respect to uv into Jacobian of uv with respect to xy is equal to, the first Jacobian has the value u into, and the second Jacobian has the value, and the second Jacobian has the value 1 upon u, and which is equal to 1. Hence proved.